high health, wellness, class 2, 保健养生研究院第二堂开始咯。保健养生研究院第二堂开始咯。Hi, for the health and wellness class number 2, we're going to have two topics today. First one is said here, strive for higher level to mental wellness with better ethic codes and moral standards. Second topic will be shown here and as promised before, to show you the nutritional information and the ADME, particular the metabolism of vitamin D3, through the organs will be covered here, and also saying show you an interesting rainbow cooking targeting our eye health. Okay. Now for the topic one, actually I have to say the Western society is doing better at present. For example, they have this EPA, FDA rules, regulation, codes, you know, to prevent our public health or the earth, the water and air environment to be polluted, which actually will have impact on the second topic, the food safety. Okay, and also Western society is doing better to you to educate or to guide the younger people when, you know, when starting, actually, I noticed starting their childhood. For example, like my daughter and my granddaughters, they are actually have the concept, the ideal to protect the earth and protect our living environment. And they also have good heart, kind heart than the Eastern society. Eastern society actually is because of Eastern education system, I think more grade are emphasized for student to put more effort there than all this other value. That's why. But actually, the we Chinese also from our ancestors has a lot of good advice. Okay, other than in school, they give us really good advice. For example, like this one is the an old philosophy. He gave this 8 virtual ability.
This philosophy, Yu Ren.
He told my husband, if you want to be a moral hero, you know, it's you should have this 8 virtue ability. This ability is from outer physical ability to the inner mind backbone ability. Actually, so far, it's very hard. So far, I cannot do it either. So far, that I think I can do it. Maybe to keep my heart and mind purity and you know, have a straight bone to not to be polluted by the immoral things. Okay, I will explain this more in the later slides. Back to the East people should learn from the Westerns ethical or professional codes or regulations, this kind of thing.
Actually that's only the base.
The base from the instant in the year of 2008, China has a milk scandal, remember? That makes many kids going for dialysis, poor kids. And then, even now, in the recent years, the issue about this Purdue pharmaceutical company made its opiates painkiller drug and result in many deaths and tragedy too. That all this kind of things that us, you know, make us think actually we should go for even higher level of mental standard. You know, it means both sides people, both Eastern and Western people, we should calibrate further for the moral compass. Okay, so this we will discuss and explain more. In this way, it's not only good for your mental wellness, actually it will benefit our society to have less tragedy like this happened. And the actually the this one this calibration or to set a better moral compass can be, you know, can be enhanced by some of the Chinese philosophies. You know, since I was young, I always remember that about this Chinese good philosophy, our ancestors tell us about this four principles and the eight virtues, 四维八德. Okay, there it includes a lot of things like the honesty and the filial respect, okay, and the kindness, justice, everything are included. This will be explained in more details in the later slides, okay? And what I'm trying to tell you is this actually always in my mind, okay, that never changed. Since starting the first time teaching in Belvin Hospital Nursing School of Hunter College, I told those students too that the honesty is the first thing. 那这里就是讲到老外西方社会他们美国英国都这样他们弄的这个各种行业的规矩我们叫做 ethic code 或者是 FDA EPA 的 regulation 什么都很严，这是我们可以学习的。 还有呢，就是说他们从小的教育，还有宗教都会引导他们去，保护这个环境跟这个社会上的一些人，他们要有慈悲的心肠，通常他们很早就这么做。因为我从我的女儿跟那个我现在在英国念书的这个孙女们身上可以看到，其实我们中国人也是很早的，很多这个哲学家给我们的 advice 其实很好，等一下我也会跟老外讲，要做到那个程度，要超过那个程度，才不会说像他们近年这个普渡那个制药厂做出来的这个会上瘾的鸦片的止痛剂造成了这十几年来很多人的上瘾跟这个甚至死亡的悲剧。那我们中国人当然我们也不能不承认，我们有时候也会有发生这样的事情，比如像那个2008年的大陆发生的这个奶粉里头的三聚氰胺的事件，还很多小孩子洗肾，这个我们都要牢记在心。OK， 所以呢，你也知道，老师每次在教你们这些课程之前，不管是环保了、制药了什么medical device 的课程，那个就是生医材料了等等这种课程，我的头一章都是道德章，你们都还记得。这就让我想起来，那个 Dora 给我有曾经给过我一张那个相片，说唯一不变的老师，在我心里头，我就想的，我唯一不变的其实就是这个东西。然后最后我在那个里面会讲到四维八德，我们那时候再来中英文讲清楚。这次我中文英文 subtitle 会弄上去，免得时间会拖得太长，这样就可以讲多一点东西。然后第二个 topic 就是延伸上次就是说老师答应你们的要讲这个关于这个维他命 D3 在身体里头器官好的话，它怎么样代谢，或者我们英文叫做 transformation， 从 D3 变成活性的 D， 这样子它才能来带动像钙啦到骨头去，带动镁到你的神经系统去，然后肌肉 去才不容易去不容易比如说这里酸那里抽筋之类的事情。 OK， 那个在第二部分会讲。然后第二部分我们还有个很有趣的，就是说会讲一个叫做 Rainbow Meal， Rainbow Meal 的话就告诉你说这有颜色的这些东西的营养成分对你不错。这次用的是老师是针对就是说如果你不吃这个食品补充来补你的眼睛的话，其实在我们就可以做这个 Rainbow Meal 来吃。那这些 Rainbow Meal 其实那个如果早餐不做它 不放早餐里面，其实在中餐晚餐其实都可以的。 OK， 好，我们现在第一个 topic 先放些 slide 来解释一下。好，
老师真的唯一不变的就是相信人心的善，然后我都喜欢说劝劝大家人可以做到诚信，然后做到四维八德，这样子的话那个四维八德让你心安理得嘛，睡得好吃得饱，那你会得到很多福气，自然走过生老病死，很不错的。那老师在这里 也想到就是说其实那四维八德里面很多事情我们教育下一代的，比如说他知道怎么样去敬老尊贤，然后他的主对教养他的或教育他的长辈 老师们当然包括父母嘛，哈，他就会从小都会表达爱，那表达尊敬，哈，这样子的爱长辈和尊敬祖先，哈，会让我们很安慰。好，我的下一代，我都常常觉得他们给我很多的安慰，里面事情。里面我们视为八德里面还讲个那个爱字，他们是比较会表达出来了。这是我们这里的父母也可以教教小孩的，还不错。八德中还有一个，还有最后有两个字很有意思的，就是说我老师就用这个来讲到，就是说不光是体外，在体内你也是一样，要避免在你身体的环境内制造战争，身体的里面的那个各种养分，哦，要保持多样化平衡化，然后要怎么样呢，让他们大家一起合作，哦，来让你的身体健康。还有很重要，当然我们像我下面讲的那个尤其早餐的时候，你要吸收的是你需要的养分，不需要的就第一个你不要 overdose， 第二个就是说要小心不要去在那时候吃到比较有毒性的东西，哦，所以这一点，哦，就从我们这个第一个主题到第二个主题里面常常讲到，就是说我们要保护我们的地球环境，保护我们的风水环境，哦，就是air 跟 water pollution 都不要，哦，那在这里头还有一个很好玩的事，哦，就是说你看到于右任给那个师长的那个八大身心道德力，老师其实是做不到全部的，尤其前六大要身体要很好的年轻人，老师但是可以做到后面两项了，那是还可以，我在努力当中就保持心灵跟骨架子的纯净嘛。这几天正好过粽子节，我就想到说，哎，那个铮铮傲骨的屈原可能就有比较具备我们讲的这八大道德力吧，好，我们现在所以纪念他也是蛮有价值的，我会跟老外解释这个故事很有意思。然后呢现在又正好是什么英女皇白金禧年在庆祝，好，全国他们全国举国上下，哇，庆祝的好开心，他们大概就是很喜欢这个女皇。这女皇96岁了，身心还保持得很好。然后呢她这一次在活动当中有好多飞机飞过来给她做了一个好好玩的，就是彩虹的各色彩虹在天上就出现了。就让我们又感谢老天，除了给我们的这个干净环境我们要保护之外，还有就是说老天给我们这个光，你知道，还有各色彩虹蔬果，我们要好好的用它来保护 我们的身心健康。第一个讲到光好了，光里面如果我们常常出去吸取光线，那你身心会很愉快。第二个，这个光里面，老师在那个以前书里头教过你们仪器分析，光里头还分很多节，那老天呢还赋予我们可以目视到这个有颜色的这个眼睛，有这个能力真的是很好，那我们就可以去采这个自然光自然彩虹饮食。这一次老师彩虹饮食会讲
彩虹食物的自然颜色，既漂亮又营养，但是合成的色素可是伤身伤大地的。我从来不去染发，也劝我的好朋友们不用染发，年纪老了的时候自然会得到一头漂亮的银发，就很自然的走过生老病死。有生之年应该要保护我们的环境，有好的风水跟土地来生产安全的食物
the natural colors of rainbow food are so beautiful and nutritious. But the synthetic pigments is very harmful to the body and the land, particularly the hair dye. I never go to dye my hair and always advise my friend not to dye the hairs. Anyway, when we grow old, we will get beautiful silver hairs and go along with nature to complete our life. As long as we live, we should keep our environment safe and healthy. SHE, safe and healthy environment, will let the farmers grow safe produces and healthy livestock. 第二个讨论的主题，从上次早餐说吃的像皇帝的丰盛这样子说起了哈，但是要注意吸收跟那个安全的问题哈，可以适当吸收，安全吸收。老师的早餐基本上用fiber 高的燕麦片和蛋，鸡鸭蛋都可以为主，再加上每日一定有一个苹果，还有我让我的胃可以活化的姜 ，OK， 姜肉还可以调整那个便便的软硬度哈，所以我保留这个姜皮这个研究哈，下次再讲，这个又需要时间了哈。那再现在比较重要是讲到苹果皮的里头抗氧化最多的地方，但不要去皮。那苹果皮，比如说像那个 quercetin， 是以前我带研究生做过分析很多次的主题，像西方药厂也在用。它但是不去皮的时候，我们可以用盐来刷汁。在欧美的农药管控严谨，盐水就可以，管控不佳的我们要想办法去研究调查，找方法去除。然后那苹果的营养很多，那个我们尽量吃，大多是这样子啦。如果说怕那个农药的话，我们想办法，就是说水溶挥发或综合方法都可以用了，但在这里盐就可以了啦，盐很有用的，下次我会讨论更多的关于盐的。对我来讲，研究过我很多次，我快晕过去，因为我原来血压掉下来的时候，我就用盐当场把我那个血压提上来，否则也蛮危险的，昏过去的话。那我们这个吃饱了以后，这一次呢还可以，还有很多东西，像鱼肉啦，或者是说这个其他的那个叫什么其他的那个有颜色的啦，蔬菜啦，蔬果哈，都可以哦。我这边还拍了一个叫做彩虹餐哈，那个呢我们可以那个等一下在后面我表演给大家看，顺便告诉大家怎么样去洗那个小小的那个黑枸杞。因为这个是因为眼睛不好的人，如果不想吃食品补充剂的话，来做这个改良式的鸡茸玉米汤就是更好了。那个我们那个一般来讲如果我们吃的饱了之后，在早餐吃饱以后，饭后你要吃什么甜点啦，要吃巧克力啦，吃 nuts 啦，其实都可以了，就比较不怕了，因为你的胃没有那么空。好，这次老师有一个重要事我想起来我要告诉你们，就是说还有那个维他命，有因为现在很多人 take 维他命 D3 的这个食品补充剂那这个食品补充剂维他命 D3 怎么样在我们身体器官里头转换成维他命 D 在这一次我就要说明 因为我们懂化学的人可以去看它的化学结构，然后它是经什么器官，它要经过我们身体的副甲状腺啦，还有这个肝啦、肾啦，把它从维他命 D3 的那个本来没有那个 OH group 的，在经过这样的代谢之后，器官要好哦，它可以转化成在第一个位置跟第二25个位置有两个官能基，有两个官能基就会变成这个维他命 D， 然后维他命 D 活化以后才可以在你身体带动一些这些矿物质，最重要的就是钙，它跟钙有很大的关系。讲到钙这个事情，很多人 有误解，下次我要花这个一两堂的时间 来解释这个事情，我们还好多事要谈。那最重要的就是说，我们不是说吃了东西就好，你看看代谢很重要，所以呢，轻微的运动，像我们中国人讲的气血要把它运行起来，然后我们才可以吸收。
要用这个早餐空腹前先不要用牙膏刷牙，因为牙膏有合成的化学物，空腹不好。下次开始我们要学会看那个，你看牙膏上的像这种产品都有 label， 这边不止这个药啦、食品啦，这些产品、化妆品都有 label 标示，还有说明哦，连那个蔬果都有。你看看老师上面放的影片，你们到各国去学习、研究、调查食物相关事项的时候，可以多学学。吃完早餐以后就不怕啦，你就可以刷牙啦、吃甜点啦、运动啦，到各处到外面去走走，吸收阳光。下次还要说这个如何正确的吸收阳光，很多人我们都搞错了。就像那个说钙跟那个维他命 D 还有那个草酸不能合吃一样的那个错，下次都会讲。还有最重要其实是不要过分摄取某一个营养补充物，也会变毒物的。下次我用锌抗病毒来说明。还有很多东西我们要学习的，这是一个长期的学习。OK， 好，下次说啦哈。好，现在用英文，就是 Before breakfast, I use sodium chloride sterilizing mouth, not the paste which contains synthetic chemicals.After the breakfast, your stomach is not empty anymore. Then you can brush your teeth with toothpaste, eating dessert, chocolate, nuts. Most importantly is to do some mild exercise at least. And the exercise can help your ADME.Also improve your immunity, which scientists has a lot of puzzle about the immunity. We will talk in the future. And the other things like vitamin D should work as carrier, balance with minerals such as calcium and magnesium. Balance with vitamin K too. And also there's puzzle how to avoid kidney stone by eating vegetables with calcium containing food. Most of people are puzzled. We will learn this next time. Okay, in the meantime, we should protectOur organs being damaged by harmful stuff such as B3P, pollutants, pesticide, pigment, by G3P, which is a pollution prevention paste that 3M's promotion. Remember? Yeah. Mild exercise, Eastern style.Will be studies.
one by one, this improve immunity. So it's worthwhile to choose the suitable ones for yourself and for your family members. Okay, so actually there's so many things still have to talk about. Oh, okay, the antioxidants, such as in apple skin, this should be covered next time too. So many things to be covered. In the future class, we'll continue to learn, study, investigate, and even solve some complicated puzzles one by one. Anyway, the lifetime learning is endless, and that's good for you. Okay, here that I summarize in English, or you can read in more detail. You read the above slides in English, that helps. Next, I'll be showing you the interesting rainbow soup cooking. Have fun! I'm going to show the cooking of a rainbow meal using this as an example. I'm using actually like corn, carrots, green leaf vegetables, and most importantly is the black wolfberry. All this, they contain the phytochemicals good for your eyes, and they have a different structure. The thing for this one is, for the black wolfberry, its phytochemicals is highly soluble and heat labor. So when I start to cook, you will see, I will pour all this first to cook, and then the black wolfberry will be aided after all other ingredients are done. Okay, and the all these things you can see, there's colors, and you know, as I mentioned in my chemical instrumentation book, those phytochemicals can be detected by photometer because they're visible color. Actually, their concentration can be measured now. But now we don't have a lab. Thank God that give us the ability to visualize all these rainbow colors from red to purple. This black wolfberry falls into the end of the visible light vision. All others, like corn, yellow corn, orange carrots, the green vegetable, they are also in the front part of the visible light. Since it's very soluble in water, what I do for cleaning is to use the salt crystal to rub it without water, because if you have water here, it's a good phytochemical components will be dissolved, and sometimes it accelerates the decomposition of those components. Okay, now it's so use the salt to do this is to kind of like, because see this this fruit has an uneven skin, so we cannot do cleaning like
for apple skin. Apple skin has a smooth skin. I didn't use the cover. It's because in case there's some pesticide or weed killer or like insecticide, those kind of poison thing. Most of those chemical structure are like having low boiling point, so they are easy to be evaporated. If you cook your the vegetables, your ingredients without cracked egg, they can put the egg drop in too. Okay, now the wolfberry are done. And as mentioned, the salt you use, you have to be careful about your own condition. That if you can take iodized one or not. Okay, I need to take this because sometimes I'm like hypothyroid condition occur. Okay.
This rainbow soup with corn is good for my lunch or dinner. My breakfast normally has enough macronutrients of dietary fiber and carbohydrates as corn can supply. After absorbing the nutrient, we should do some light exercise activities to enhance ADME, particular metabolism. There are more details and stories about ADME and the organs involved will be studied in the future classes from time to time. 好，老师把那个煮彩虹玉米汤的说明用中文 slide 摆上面就好了哈。最重要的是我们呢气血运行要来帮助这个 ADME 哈，尤其是代谢这个将来哈。我们在课堂上还要讨论很多的 ADME 跟器官，有益眼力的改良彩虹餐不错吧？你们也可以设计合适自己或家人的彩虹餐哦。玉米是端午节建议的食物之一，属于黄色系列的，糖分会稍高一些。那我午晚餐吃当然比较合适了，如果怕糖分的人哈，在有空的时候吃完了哈之后就可以吃一些甜品了哈，然后稍微运动，用那个中国式的运动会比较好哈，来增加气血运行，吸收代谢会增加，不再需要去药房购买补充剂了。 OK， 好，也可以走去喜欢的地方，街头博物馆什么都好啊，给你作画很开心的助消化，睡前我就跟孙女跳跳舞助眠也是很棒。好，现在下一集就再见你们啦，还好多要谈的，现在是父亲节前夕推出这个今天跟你们说端午节跟父亲节快乐啦，安康啦，好多的题目有待研究，下次见咯，好不好？好，下次见。 So much to be studied in the future. I see you next time. Now you have a happy Father's Day.